He stares at you in disbelief, but this is... His face twists as he struggles for words. They said you were a kind soul, but I wouldn't have imagined. This will see me out of the city, and well away. I'm not sure I could ever thank you enough, but here, take this. I hope it's some use to you on your journey. You have my lasting gratitude, friend. I should get ready. He thanked me and told me he would never forget my kindness. We got rabbit fur gloves, huh? Oh, properties of crit multiplier, bonus 10%. Rabbit fur gloves appeared in the Durance fables and bedtime stories for hundreds of years, typically as lucky gifts to individuals of particular virtue. The gloves were first mentioned in a bedtime story about a girl who, in the midst of a famine, gave a piece of fruit to an elderly crone. The old woman in turn gave rabbit fur gloves to the girl, and though it was summer, she accepted them graciously. She wore them and managed to forage enough to feed her family, and a few short seasons later she became a hunter of uncanny skill. In other stories, the gloves are given to brave warriors, hard-working servants, and honest shopkeepers. The last story to mention the gloves is that of the notorious pickpocket Sandurian, who lost them when he stole an apple from a wizened old crone. So he stole an apple. Although the gloves appear to be sewn from the fur of different rabbits, there is no detectable seam between the many colored pelts. They're soft and cozy, yet when you put your hands in them, your fingers still feel quick and nimble. A rabbit's foot dangles from the left glove, and their natural warmth suggests the presence of essence. If we had our druid with her, she would, or a ranger actually, she would hate that. So, crit multiplier bonus plus 10. For a dare. For his crits. We really don't have anything in our hands. Well, Aeloth has Fulvano's gloves. Completed. This wobbly little tent is barely standing. The smoldering fire is strewn with the meager remains of a recent meal. Fish bones, a molded rind of cheese, and a blackened bread crust. Ooh, camping supplies. And two lockpicks. We can't take these here, but we can camp here. And then retrieve them. Trapped?
Quickly and quietly.
The queen that was and still is, we have that. Gonna leave it. We should come back here. And by now you're probably watching another episode. We split this into two because... we went on for a while.
Hello? Hello?
Shut up, Canna. Who yells out hello when you're sneaking? Right, there's still those stairs down. Ooh. Dank spore? Ugh. Alright. Bring it on, you dank thing. Lock and load. Oh, we have to go down there to fight it? Probably gonna run into something else. Was a troll too? Okay, we didn't get to go much. Amplified thrust. Minor missiles. Did I change his weapon? Yeah. I don't think we can knock down a troll. I always try, though. Is that it knocked down? I guess that's what it looks like knocked down. It looks like it's hunched over, I can't even tell. It was, yeah. Cannon, what are you doing?
Following your lead.
You are not following my lead. Bad answer. Why can't I switch to her? Oh, she's confused. Oh, she's in a confused state. Oh, she's an enemy right now. Duh. Yeah, just realized that. Well, let's get the hell away from her then.
Yes?
Not too bad at all. Not too bad. Any goodies from this thing? No?
Of course.
Troll skin. Nummies. Potion of Bulwark Against the Elements. Creates a mystical shield around a caster, suffusing them with bonus to freeze, burn, corrode, and shock damage reductions. There's another one. I didn't realize there was another one so close. They're not too tough. Let's say we all pile on this thing. They confuse us, though. Another thing. Oh, another troll. Sporelings. Oh, crap. Okay, Palagina. We have company. Take this thing down. Oh, fireball. Oh, and there's another thing down back there. Knock down. Holy Radiance. Attack. Which one's Theodos? This one? Okay, so she can cast her spell. She might not be engaged in melee combat, so... But I have no idea what this thing's gonna do, and they're gonna run around us and stuff, so... Amplify Thrust off of Adair. Actually, no. Off of... Palagina. Sporeling's tough, maybe? I always forget where Bless is. Blessing. Wow. So she's engaged in melee. Theodos. Kill this troll. Oh my god, Amethyst. I mean, Amethyst. Theodos. Is she confused now or something? Flanked. Well, let's see if she can cast it. Okay, the troll is down. Durance, Adair, Theodos. Okay. Hit that one. Dare, hit that one. Knockdown, actually. If that'll work on that thing. Theodos, heal yourself if you can. She did, okay, good. Actually... There's a more obvious way I can heal her. I guess Durance was interrupted. Some of us aren't doing so well. Near death. Oh, it's... Okay, there's our healing. Light Endurance to Aeloth, if we can do it. Oh, he's down. Moderate. Where's Durance? That's him. Soul ignition? Can we do it? Deidas, Adair. Knockdown.
And?
Durance is down. Yeah, kinda. He's confused, he's running off. Crap. Mentally leaked. How nearby do we have to be? I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, he's back. Kanna's back. Attack this thing. The rest of us are doing okay for now. Oh, Kanna's fighting us again. Get this thing. Don't hit him.
Quay?
Yes, Quay. Damn.
Sure.
That was pretty hefty. Sixty-five silver loose from the skeleton and from our enemies. Dank spores. These small, feather-thin spores have delicate, stinging barbs by which they cling to surfaces, passing creatures, and the insides of nostrils. Are they worth anything? Not much. And more of that crap and troll skin. Wow.
Be cautious. Be constant.
As long as they're not constantly dead, it's a good thing. I have no idea how big this... Well, we're about reaching the end of the map. What is this? Oh, we have to supposed to loot this person? It's showing us that on the map. Oh, what do we get? I've missed it. Something to stash. Oh, a troll skin? That's it? No. Is that a glitch or something? See that? How it shows that like that? Hmm. Sneak past the door. I don't know. We haven't seen anything burst through doorways, but I wouldn't be surprised if they put it in there to surprise us. I realize what I just said, I wouldn't be surprised if they, you know, wanted to surprise us. Alright. So. Now we can go in here. I'm assuming we can rest. So since what's-his-name was resting. On the fire. That's funny, we got grass growing in here. You awake to see Durance, his staff held in both of his hands before him. A flame flickers at its top end, casting long shadows across his face as he stares in contemplation. Still, for all the lack of the fire, your eyes can't focus on him. Perhaps it is awakening from sleep or a trick of the light, but he seems indistinct, blurred around the edges, everything except for the staff. The staff, he seems to be studying its engravings. As you watch, the engravings glow thinly red, like through the cracks of heat-suffused wood. The lines stream like molten metal, burning along the edges of his staff, then branch out in an intricate series of fiery veins, bunching thickly where his hands clutch the wood, pulsing as if a heartbeat. As you watch, the veins spiral into a dozen separate circles, circles that spiral again until they are arranged in a circle of their own. They pulse, wait, and all is strangely silent. And then suddenly there is a great light from the fire, a rushing of air, a great flash, and you awaken again to see Durance in the same place, still holding his staff, but he is solid, real. He doesn't seem to have noticed you, or reacted to what occurred. What the hell? As though something in his soul was revealing itself to me, I should ask him what I saw. Okay, before I forget, let me grab that camping supply to make four again. And yeah, let's talk to him. Does something ail you? Well, hey Durance, the game said you wanted to talk to me. I had questions I wanted to ask you.
If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
I saw something strange. You were sitting by the fire, and I saw a great light from your staff.
Tell me what you saw.
Durance is silent, staring at you, locking gazes. It was a flash like an explosion, a rushing of air, incredibly bright.
It is the light of the Godhammer you saw.
Durance takes in each word. He is strangely silent for a moment, and when he speaks, his voice is low. The Godhammer? What about it?
It was a weapon of Deerwood's people, a symbol of their independence. It saved the Deerwood.
What do you know about it?
It brought the Saints' War to an end, knocked a god from his perch. There are few that would deny Aothis overstepped. The Godhammer reminded Aothis of it.
Durance's voice remains low, steady, as if repeating something he's said many times before, either out loud or to himself.
You saw its light because I helped shape it, give it life, and release it into the world. Once seen, its glory is almost too bright to be believed, and too bright to be forgotten.
You helped build the Godhammer?
There were 12 of us.
He nods.
We fashioned the weapon, drafted plans for it, prayed for guidance at Ashfall, and it came to me there. Each of us were given a staff made from the forest of black trees around us, glowing with embers and fire far greater than this branch you see now. It felt as if the staff was Margrin's own finger, guiding my hand, guiding the other 11, the shadows of the 12 who had come to stand on the bridge to stop Aethys.
Shadows of the 12?
Even in that stand, there was a ritual to it. For the 12 that stood on the bridge, there were a dozen shadows cast, a dozen faithful of Margrin, her fiercest supporters and shapers of the Godhammer.
Durance rests the staff in front of him, and the flame atop it curls for a moment, the light flaring slightly. It splits into a ring of flames, one after the other, until a dozen is met.
As 12 held Aethys fast, we 12 unleashed our prayers and let the godhammer fall.
Then it blossoms brightly, once, and resumes its candle intensity. In the aftermath, the shadows seem sharper in the vicinity, as if they have edges, and you blink to clear your vision. Durance is still staring at the tiny candle-like flame, intently.
Shadows cast by the fire of the godhammer, perhaps. And we share their fate as well in time. Now the spine of the Deerwood is marked by the godhammer. Marked by Magrin.
The flame suddenly winks out, smokeless. Durance frowns and moves his gaze from the staff. What do you mean, shared their fates?
Not all deaths come with stilled breath and stilled heart. Or other stilled passions beneath the waste. Some deaths come from silence. The connection we once shared with Magrin. After the light of the Godhammer, it was not the same. It was as if we'd lost our senses, and sense of purpose as well. Instead of victory, being welcomed, there was silence within and without. Not many can claim to have killed a god. It is less a heroic tale than you would think. And such a death, it changed our faith. All faiths, I expect. Doubt followed, and the world changed. I do not believe Magrin was pleased by what we had done.
Why is that?
The world is broken. The wheel stilled. There is sickness in the world's heart. Perhaps the price of crossing a god.
Durance scratches at his pock scar, then stops and withdraws his hand, studying it, frowning.
Crossing two gods? Even as Magrin shaped our hands, perhaps we carried her will farther than was allowed.
He pauses.
Just as Widewind did. Saint Widewind.
He spits.
Mortal arrogance to match mortal arrogance. Yet if the world had changed, then I sought to change with it. If I had forgotten some of Magrin's teachings, I would find them again. I would make her see me again.
What did you do?
I remembered Margaret's teachings. How reminders on the flesh were more important than the death of a vessel.
He frowns.
And I wondered if killing Aethys, if that had simply set him free, had it allowed him to escape his punishment and be taken on the wheel, like a mortal?
With that sentence, Durance's voice takes an odd upturn. For once, it feels like he is genuinely asking a question. He shakes his head.
As I stepped from the now blessed Godhammer Bridge, I thought of Ashfall. I thought of the War of Black Trees. Wondered if I needed to be burned to find myself again. That is Magrin at her heart. At least that is my hope.
He frowns.
These are the doubts that befall me.
What happened when you returned to Ashfall?
The road to Ashfall is long. Gives one time to think. And if you think long enough, you do not go home. I left without telling anyone, with only the robes I wore at Halgott, my staff, and my name, which is long buried. Of my fellow 11 craftsmen, disciples, I know not what happened to them, if they suffered the same doubt as I did. But it was underserved. It was wrong. We had done all that. Or had asked. Grabbed victory from defeat and...
So two things to say. You feel as if your god has betrayed you, or if you betrayed your god. One's a statement, the other's a question. You feel as if your god has betrayed you.
There is something about being used and cast aside. Perhaps Widewind himself felt it. There at the end, when the hammer struck. to be the proof that your god is hollow as the vessel it inhabits. I tried to find purpose, and avoided all contact with other Magranic priests, did not seek the walls of Ashfall, and sought to make amends to my god through actions. I joined with the purges for a time, and not long after came the first signs of the Hollowborn.
He frowns.
So many crimes, trespasses, violations.
He spits.
The Salvation. Animancers were another sickness born of the Saints' War. A relapse of innovation, of desperation to heal what we had caused. All seemed worse than before the bridge, not better. And as years passed, the world became even worse still for the victory.
Maybe the purges weren't what Magran wanted either. Sweat collects in the sooty creases of his forehead and runs down his ruddy cheeks. It drips from the tip of his nose. His mouth moves, but his utterances make no sound. He is, for once, at a loss. Feeling your gaze, he quickly composes himself, wiping his forehead with the back of a dirty hand.
Huh? Worship the whims of some fickle bitch, and you'll never be more than dirt beneath her feet. Worship what she worships, on the other hand. Take her fire for your own, and her esteem comes on its own. Of course, by that time you no longer need it. Trial and transformation, sure as Durance taught.
Durance glares at you, and staring into his eyes gives you the feeling of peering over the edge of a great cliff. Wow.
You think to put the coals to my feet, but what's burned once will never burn again. These talks are your trial, Watcher. You cannot deflect the truth to one who has already been purified by it.
Tell me what happened on the bridge. We chose the bridge because we could control it. Durance's hands tighten at the top of his staff, as if holding it by the neck. It was a place where we could choke Aethys in his own footsteps, where we knew his feet would fall, a narrow neck of stone. But it was more than that. It was a spine of the Deerwood, symbolic of its backbone. Such symbols are important in the construction of a weapon. Durance studies his staff, his eyes traveling along the etchings. Any weapon. His face hardens, and his eyes burn, his eyebrows narrowing. I suspect Aethys knew that as well, and so did his vessel in its arrogance. His hand tightens on the staff. He intended to walk upon the bridge as if walking on the backs of the Deerwood. And we intended to burn him with the light of our faith, and his. 12 on the bridge, 12 in the shadow, and gave ourselves to it. Gave yourselves to it?
We put much of ourselves into the Godhammer. Such a device is not simply a machine. There are elements of the spirit in it.
He frowns.
Even Widewind's spirit.
Elements of the spirit?
Each of the 12 who brought the Godhammer forth would have done anything to save the Deerwood, save its people. It is why we were chosen. Each of us hated this pretender. That rage, that spirit, that rebellion went into our work, and went into studying him as well.
Widewind? Why?
We all studied Widewind. He was our enemy, and he had provided the flesh the god wore as a cloak. That flesh made him vulnerable. I knew what fields his hands had tilled, his family, what he had harvested, where he had been born. We sought to know him, what had led him to fight us.
Why was that important?
You don't kill the god. You kill the man it inhabits. And you leave that man a ruin. Burn him to ash. The weapon was meant to not only burn his flesh, but it would burn his soul. And it did. At the cost of our own. And at the cost of our goddess's favor. That whore be damned.
Is that why your image was blurred in a dream? Durance frowns, glances at you with a sharp look. Perhaps your eyes are blinded by the God's Hammer's light, Watcher. He snorts. I may feel half a man at times, but even that is twice that of most others.
If you fear for my spirit, your fears are baseless. The Godhammer, seeing its light, only fueled my anger and made me stronger. Made me re-examine the teachings of Margrin. Put them in a new light.
It looked as if there was only part of you, as if your spirit had been sheared in half.
I do not need you to cast any more questions on me, Watcher. Nor did I ask you to look upon me without my leave. Get gone, and leave me be.
Durance snarls, his face a feverish red. I was just telling you what's in my dream, guy. Durance revealed that he was one of the engineers of the Godhammer bomb. There must be more that he isn't telling me, at least not yet.
What?
Your face is full of need, he snorts. It looks to burst if you didn't speak.
If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
Tell me more about Ashfall. He grunts. You're more curious about it than most of Magrin's faithful. What else can you tell me about Ashfall? What's more to tell? He frowns, his hands tightening on the staff again, his fingers seeming to sink into the wood. It is one of the greatest fires of Magrin, the High Seat, he shrugs. Some say the blackest, not of evil, but of ash, all that remains after fire has fed. He pauses. I called it a cathedral before. That's not the full truth of it. It's more of a battlefield. It lies in the heart of the War of Black Trees, its timbers built from the burnt forest there, each timber blessed by fire and one of Magrin's greatest battles. Many of us helped shape the war effort there with flames and firearms. What is the cathedral like? Massive, beautiful, blessed by the goddess. Flames cannot strike it twice. His eyes travel to his ashen staff, studying the etchings. Beneath, tunnels and chambers, bellows and fire pits, and many of the faithful, looking for a means to bring fire to the world. He turns his gaze from the staff to you. Guns, explosives, alchemy. All of these are our holy symbols, and we are eager to share. That staff of yours looks like your holy symbol. Do you have whale's eyes painted on your skin? There's more mysteries than questions, and even a matching force of answers won't placate you. Even soldiers need to let their thoughts settle, just as their priests do. I'm not done talking to you, dude.
What?
You heard me.
If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
Durance is an odd name. No more than Watcher. And Durance is not a name, it is a title. What does your title mean? It's as if you swallowed a gadfly nest. Keep silent and keep them to yourself, lest you tire yourself before the next campfire. Oh, come on, guy.
What? If doubts and curiosity plague you,
you don't dress like a priest, and your robes look as if they were touched by fire. Keep troubling me, and I may extend the tithe bowl for each question. Enough questions for now. Let the road keep us until our next campfire. All right, fine.
Sure. Got it.
Okay. Stay tuned for next episode when we explore more around here. Can't be too much more. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.